I guess maybe I'll just start from the top, from the very beginning. The truth is, I've been living a lie. I'm not really into punk rock.
Yeah. Well, after working with Mike and Tom for a good long time, like a decade or more, you kind of get to see the dynamic and the roles that everyone plays. And ours, as you know, testified by many people, is Mike's the dad, Tom's the mom, and I'm the kid.
So. See, I gotta disagree with that a little bit. I still give Yuri the kid thing.
I don't want to be the kid.
Because he's kind of like, you know, he goes along with whatever, just like you do when you're a kid. Like, your parents want to go on some road trip and you're just kind of stuck going along with it.
Being the kid's no fun.
But I'd go with Mike being the mom more than me being the mom. Because he kind of nags a bit.
Yeah, that's funny. It's funny because I'm like the sort of parent figure where everybody calls me and says, hey, you know, are we practicing today? Because if not, I'm going to do this or that or that. And, you know, if I say we're practicing.
He's kind of like, you know, he sort of comes in and this is how it's going to be. And you do this and you do that. And that's all obviously good and bad. You know, if we didn't have that dynamic, if we didn't have that character, you know, things wouldn't run smoothly, you know, like they do.
He'll get like, you know, dude, what's going on? I need you to do this. Or like, hey, why haven't we done this yet? Or I can't believe we're going to do this. And I think I'd be more of the dad because I'm just kind of like, okay, whatever, honey. Yeah, you go do it. I'll be there. Yeah.
Well, you know, Tom's the mom in other ways too, which is funny because one time we were flying to Australia and Tom had individually wrapped pizzas for us.
Damn. Who's calling? It's Tom. Hello? What? Practicing? I don't think we really have time to practice, do you? Nobody ever calls me and goes, hey, we're practicing today. It's just like, practicing?
Yeah, you're making dumb jokes. What are you meeting about? Like, and when?
I don't know if Tom.
Here except for you, basically. So if you're not doing anything, come over. We can go now.
Yeah, we'll come over. We're gonna do a couple. We'll be over like within a half hour.
They just fight like crazy. You can't believe it. The arguments they get in, I sit there and listen, and I'm like, that doesn't make any sense. What?
Stop it. You stop it. Stop it.
Stop it.
Stop it.
Stop it. Stop it. It's funny because me and Tom, we fight sometimes. He'll be like, why are you copping a toot? And I'll be like, I'm not copping a toot. And then I start laughing going, you just said toot. And I just said toot because you just said toot.
I think that's
all right, guys, all right, come on. All right, break it up, you guys. All right, shut down the camera. We're done. Turn it off.
Man, we have some crazy fans out there. Like,
it's kind of funny because having fans still feels really weird to me, totally foreign.
Yeah, our fans are awesome too, because they just, you know, they get pretty into it. Like, we've had kids show up and paint their faces like...
Face painters.
Kids that are just so cool, you know, but they're totally like, ugh.
I wanted to say hi to the guys, to Michael and Thomas and Yuri.
Mike's face for Prez.
Just his face.
Just his face.
Made that.
I know.
Oh, we get hate mail. Oh, yeah. You're not enough this way, or you're too much that way, or I don't like the way you think about this.
They're just so mad at us for doing something so stupid, like selling out. I mean, what's wrong with that?
My friend's baby's mama told me that he saw you and Yuri.
Actually, we got a really funny letter. So funny that we had to name our album after it. It said, man, you guys are slowly going the way of the buffalo. So thank you, guy. I used to know your name, I don't anymore.
We get more hate mail from fans' parents.
Dear sirs, I'm writing to you concerning a one on this little membership with you. Please cancel all mags, clubs, fan, or whatever items she has bought from you. If any more of your trash comes to my mailing address for a one, I will file a lawsuit on damages done to my daughter's mind.
So we looked around on all our mailing lists. We couldn't find this lady anywhere.
I'm gonna give her a call. Where's my phone? Mrs. Hans. Hi, this is Mike with MXPX.
Yeah. Yeah, I got your letter here about damages done to my daughter's mind. I'm quoting your letter. I was just wondering maybe if you could help me out and explain a little further what damages we've actually done to your daughter's mind. Uh-huh. I see. No way. Yeah. Class of 95. You went there too. That's so great. We'll have to get together. It's a date. All right. I'll talk to you soon. All right. Bye.
What do you think, man? Leave me alone. I'm going to the bathroom.
Sound like this on the record though.
I'm broken hearted, broken hearted for you. So don't get me started on repairs.
I just noticed something, Mike.
What's up?
There's a big picture crotch on the wall, man.
Wow.
Alright. And it looks good.
Hey, appreciate that.
Hey, I guess I didn't realize what stress really was until we had, you know, these three shows coming up, which aren't just regular shows. So many different songs, the production, we're videotaping. Plus, we've got the AC EP, which we've been recording. We just decided to do it last minute.
So an acoustic EP, MXPX isn't necessarily known for our acousticness. Tom and I sat down in the studio and pretty much just played together. Sorry, no, not played together.
Cut.
So Tom and I sat down, busted out the acoustics, and started playing songs together. We wanted to do something completely different on this record, and not completely different like, it's crazy, it's whack, but completely different from what we feel comfortable doing. You don't really hear us on acoustic guitars picking, doing stuff like that, so Invitation to Understanding was a familiar song to most of our fans.
Standing, visit me for once today. I'll be grateful you don't even have to stay.
Invitation to Understanding has always been a song that Mike has really been into, and we thought it'd be kind of cool for this. And for a while, it was going to be kind of a rocked out version, and then we started playing around with it, and we just realized we could do this kind of cool, really mellow acoustic version of it.
You got knocking at my door and I am not around. Foolishness came by and we're downtown.
We did it on At The Show, a live version. And I felt like, you know, it's a song that's always been one of my favorites, but we really haven't done a lot live. So, you know, I really wanted to do something different with it. And so we completely changed the style of the song.
The mellow acoustic version of it, it would sound really cool and very different from the album. That's what we wanted to do. We didn't want to do everything so straight up.
What? Okay.
You're hitting 14 pretty hard and you did the murdered.
Okay.
Right here.
I'm just trying to make sense of it all, man.
Well,
like we had a theme night one night or whatever it was, you know.
Well, every now and then in Bremerton, we get bored. And we fight that boredom by doing theme nights. And a while ago, we did a 70s theme night where we did a had a 70s party and a roller skate jam.
Hi, everybody.
Hey,
73, woo!
Hey, we should have some sort of like 70s or 80s party.
Well, just, I don't know, it's funny, it's fun to do things that you wouldn't normally do.
Check out these guys and see what they're doing.
Who is this?
Hey,
is
hey,
he cool?
Hey,
do you know
no,
him? Is he cool?
No,
is he
no.
Cool?
Anybody can just go out, go to a bar, go to a movie, go bowling, do whatever.
Let's get out of here.
Nothing going on over here.
It takes guts and it takes imagination to actually have a theme night and dress up and make a complete fool out of yourselves.
Yuri, do some backwards skating for us.
You're so Yuri.
I can't
do it on the carpet.
Yeah, baby.
There's a roller skating rink around here that we all used to go to as kids, and we were just like, man, we haven't been there forever.
I fell down a lot. I'm not the best skater. I'm not the worst. I can skate pretty well, but just when you get all those people together, all this energy.
They must have thought we were the strangest people in the world. And we were there just having a good time and, you know, get looks from these people. And but it was a blast. We had a good time.
Your 50th time, you gotta do the clap. You gotta sing your hearts out. Cause we're feeling this, alright?
MXPX. We're not quite finished yet. We haven't seen the last of us. But it's crazy, we've been a band for 12 years. We got together in the summer of 1992 before we started high school. It's been a long and windy road. You know, it's been a good road. I want you guys to sing with me. Sing as loud as you can, as good as you can. I don't care. Today didn't have to be this way.
We've been everywhere together as guys.
Touring is a totally different life. Or you could say touring is a life unto its own.
We started the band right when we started high school, basically. So all we've really known for our adult lives is traveling, playing music, playing in a band, back and forth. Well, I think it should go like this. No, I think it should go like this. Well, I think I need some coffee.
Lyrically, we've got a lot more experience to feed from. Meet a lot of different people on tour, good and bad.
If you're brave, you do number two in there, but normally, no, that's a number one.
Can someone tell me why I'm feeling this way? Can someone tell me why this world is...
We've been touring Japan for a while now, and man, we have a lot of fun over there. It's just such a different place.
Banana.
You plug this into your little plug-in on your phone, and then you talk on the banana, like, hello. No, no, I'm calling from a banana.
Everything
right now.
Everything is small in Japan. Everything.
You're gonna eat it.
good.
I got a boat.
I'm out of light bulbs. I think I'm gonna go down to the light bulb store.
Japan's cool. It is such a foreign country that, you know, everyone thinks that, you know, Japanese people, they love American culture. They, you know, they all speak English. It's cool.
Japanese is such a cool language. Arigato gozaimasu.
Final answer.
I knew it.
You go over there, you know, you ask someone like, hey, how do you get to the train to Shibuya? And they'll be like, yes, thank you very much.
You can't read anything. You feel like you're 2 years old, you know?
No, seriously, I need to get to the train to Shibuya. I need to get down there to, like, you know, this club. And they'll be like, yes, thank you very much.
It's heaven.
I love
it.
Let's get out of here. Are you done yet?
All right, I'll juggle cheese one more time. Ready? Here we go. That's all I got.
Check it out. They've got all the good stuff here.
Oh yeah.
Of half the size.
See? Refrigerator opens up both ways.
What?
Yeah, exactly.
That's do that again.
About. See?
Magic tricks.
It happens each time, whatever you want.
Let me get you off.
A lot of technology here, and you know what? It's all free. It's my new laptop.
Yeah, the one-handed laptop.
You're gonna give someone 11 cents for collecting seizures.
Have you rather put on top of your car?
Yeah.
It's insane, the people over there. They are like the best fans in the entire world, for sure.
Any foreign country, you don't have the luxury of just like going wherever and calling people, and there's not as much internet access. There's just a lot less to do.
Go right now.
When we were in Europe this last time, our one day off, we were playing about an hour outside of Amsterdam, so we were like, we gotta go to Amsterdam, whoop it up on our day off. Well, our bus driver had different plans. And he wanted to go to Bruges, Belgium. And so we were like, what the heck? You know, we thought we were getting totally shafted.
Smith can do that shit. Bang it,
Black! In the sack! We're back!
We were sharing a bus with Strike Anywhere and some of their guys and Tom. And
like three of them showed up with, everyone in Europe rides these bikes, just all around, just these little dorky bikes. And they were like, dudes, we found a bike rental place.
Let's go, let's party, let's go ride bikes.
And we were like, take us there, show us where it is. So we rode on like the handlebars and on the backs of the bikes and stuff. And they took us like a mile into town. We found this bike rental place.
And I've got the camera, because I'm like, I'm not going to miss this. I had to document it. It was just the funnest day. Like, we had all day off, and all we did was ride bikes all over the place.
It was super cool, cobblestone streets. And we literally just had some beers and rode bikes around for a couple hours. It was a blast, man. We had so much fun.
I make the circle and I make party in the square. I don't know, maybe perhaps.
All jumped on these bikes, started cruising around town. It ended up being the funnest day in Europe I've ever had.
I wonder if I am in the shot. Sort of.
Yeah, usually without you. I'm probably not in the shot.
Yeah, you are. You are right now.
Oh, I know.
Dude, Yuri just cut the out of his hand.
Really?
Yeah, like he threw a bottle and it like cut the out of his hand.
He smashed a bottle.
It's a long story, but...
That's the best part, dude, right there.
And I hadn't really eaten dinner. I think I had like a slice of bread that was in the back of the freezer on the bus or something. And so we had all these beer cans all over the parking lot. And I found this big stick and I thought, hey, it'd be fun to set the beer cans up on this trash can and just start whacking them. Oh! So I was having a good time and hit one of them off, didn't break it. So I decided to finish it off while it was on the ground. And I just came down like this and just bashed my hand into all that broken glass.
There you go. Eye in the ball.
Kill it!
Kill it!
Did
you just cut yourself?
Yeah. See it?
It's not too bad.
Depends on how deep it is.
Yeah, it might be. He's dead. He's gonna die.
And I woke up the next day, we were getting on the ferry crossing from France to England, and he had just like pieces of white towel just wrapped around his fingers, and I could see blood kind of soaking through it. I was like, Yuri, what, did you get in a fight or something? He's like, nah, dude, I accidentally punched a glass bottle on the ground and it cut up my hand real good. And I was like, smart move, dude.
I was a little embarrassed because it was such a stupid move, but I had a good time nonetheless.
Go for what?
We're in Australia, so we're
going. Australia, so obviously the water drains the opposite way, Southern Hampshire, so.
Here we go.
I couldn't even tell which way it was going.
I could. The camera didn't lie.
Alright, Mike, I want you to come in and do your confessionals now and be really honest about it. We're going to protect your identity. Don't worry about it. Nobody's going to see who you are.
Alright, I just want to make sure, though, that nobody can see me. You guys can't see me.
No, nobody can see who you are. We've got you silhouetted. We can't tell it's you.
Alright, and change my voice, maybe.
Yeah, we'll change your voice and nobody's going to know. Don't worry.
Cool.
You guys are going to conceal my voice, right?
Oh, yeah, nobody's going to know it's you. Don't worry about it.
Because I've always wanted to sound like Popeye. Is that cool?
All right, Tom, it's your turn. I want you to come in here and give us a little bit of a confessional. I want you to be really honest and really just expose yourself and bare it all for the camera, okay?
No problem.
Whoa, wait. What are you doing? What are you doing?
He said to bare it all.
No, put your pants back on, man.
I tell people, you know, that I love the Descendants and that I love Black Flag. I love The Clash, I love The Ramones, but really I've just been into folk music for as long as I can remember. I grew up listening to Joni Mitchell, Joan Baez, Simon and Garfunkel. You know, The Sound of Silence was the sound of my life. That was my story.
I haven't really told the guys yet, but I've been accepted into Harvard Law, and I'm quitting the band in about a month, and I'm gonna, you know, take out all the piercings, going to tattoo removal, I've been seeing a good doctor, and I'm gonna become a lawyer because this whole world of punk rock, you know, it's been a lie the whole time. I've been reading, you know, the Wall Street Journal a lot, and just, you know, the Harvard Law Review, and it's just where my heart really is.
I always consider myself a visionary, and I've never told Mike or Tom this, but, and I don't think they should know either, is like, I've really just used the band as a jumping off point to go on to bigger and better things.
I love the wood and the earth and the sea crashing against the waves and the waves crashing against the rocks. I just had to get that off my chest.
So my heart's really been into corporate law in particular. I feel like I really want to go into setting up tax shelters for just oil companies, and I think they've really been treated unfairly, and I mean, we need the oil, and I don't care who we have to invade, you know, to get it, but we need the oil.
You know, I thought I'd only be in this band 6 months. It's been 12 years. Well, what am I doing? My new plan is this. In 6 months, I want to be the lead singer of MXPX. And through a lot of coercing, I got Mike to let me play a little bit of guitar and sing a little bit of backup vocals on one song.
And in the spirit of giving you guys a special show, Yuri, for the first time ever on guitar. Yeah. On a fake guitar.
That's right, this is like a regular sound. It's all for...
It's not really plugged in. We got the tracks in the back. That's why we're so good. I promise, this is the last acoustic song, then we rock. And then we ride! Yuri, you ready to kick it?
Yes, sir!
Everybody give it up for Yuri. And
thank you.
That's right, I was going to say, he may never come back to the front of the stage if you don't give him a warm welcome.
That's right.
Let's go. All right.
See, we're stalling because I don't want to actually play anything.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, all right, next song.
All right, we're done. And that was Yuri's time on the front of the stage. We're done.
Yeah, yeah. Kick it.
I really think once I'm in charge, we're gonna go huge. We're gonna take it to the top.
We do this thing called the bass toss where I throw my bass to our bass tech, he throws it back to me. And it's just like a guitar change, except it's like a circus guitar change because it's like flying through the air.
The thing with the bass toss is it's really cool and it gets the crowd stoked and it's a fun thing to do, but the problem with the bass toss is it can just go so wrong.
Oh!
And he threw it a little too far and there were, the headlining band's guitar amp was right there. I had the bass went over it, and I knocked into their amp and it fell down on the ground and I tried to catch it and it freaked me out. It slammed on the ground, probably broke all the tubes. I ran. I never looked back.
There's just all this stuff we do. I mean, and the funny thing is like out on tour, there's not constantly a camera rolling. There's not always somebody there to document, but every day there's something that happens.
Yeah, being in the bus, for months or whatever, you definitely get on each other's nerves.
Yeah, our tour manager passes out sometimes, and we do stuff with him. And that particular night, we decided to see if we could make him go pee by putting his hand in warm water.
One night we got really bored on the bus, and we just, obviously there's nothing to do on tour, so you have to make things up.
He's a heavy sleeper. Like when he falls asleep, he's a bear. He's not waking up ever for anybody. We got some plexiglass one time and we taped it over his bunk, so when he woke up in the morning, tried to get out, just a big wall there.
It's awesome.
He was sitting with his hand outside the bunk, and of course, as we're walking by, we're seeing this and we're going, oh, ho, ho. I think he peed his pants many times. I don't know if it was because of the warm water.
You're supposed to pee by now. Thomas!
Later on, Tom, of course, was sleeping, passed out somewhere in his bunk. So we all go into the bus and we're like,
I was just done. It had been a long day and we had a day off and we'd been walking around all day in Bruges.
Hello, hello. Wait, hold on, I'm gonna pinch his nipple really hard real quick, hold on. Shh.
He actually didn't even wake up. He was just like, nothing, like he was just there.
Wait, watch.
I don't remember that.
Oh, no?
I might have been asleep. I'm asleep for a lot of this stuff.
I barely remember. I thought I had some weird dream that they were messing with me, but apparently it was a reality. I don't know. So all these practical jokes, you know, me getting kind of messed with when I was sleeping, same thing with Tommy with the hand in the water. You know, seems that Mike's behind a lot of these, and I don't really remember getting him all too often. And I don't remember getting him for a long time, so I think over these next few days we gotta do something to him, we gotta get him somehow. So I guess this is just a warning to you, Mike. Don't fall asleep anywhere I can find you.
When it comes to criticism, I take it pretty hard. And I don't always take it the right way. I don't always take it as, hey, let's get better at this, let's make this happen. I had to be the first person to criticize somebody else and go, hey, this needs to be done, this needs to get made right. Why is this not happening? But when it comes to me, why you keep screwing up that bass line, or why can't you remember the words to that song?
You know, I think you should probably go back and sing the second chorus, because there's starving children in Rwanda who would want you to sing it better. So do it for them, Mike.
You know, the way that things work with this band is, you know, Mike writes the songs and everything, and everyone knows that, but he'll come out with a song and he'll think it's right on, you know, and a lot of time, me and Yuri will have things to say about it, you know, because we have opinions too. You know, he bums out sometimes, but in the end, you know, it all works out. You know, I'm sure he gets his feelings hurt a little bit and everything, but it's been so many years of it that I'm sure he's used to it by now.
Tom and Yuri, why do they have to be so mean all the time? I can sing. I don't forget the words. Well, most of the time. Okay, let's pull it together. Maybe I shall. Yeah. Come on, Mike. Let's do this.
You guys have been an amazing crowd. Thanks for being part of this, part of history. And thanks for the support. This goes out to you guys. Thank you. Don't want this responsibility. Don't use me, cause I don't agree. Think about it, we'd be better off without it. Hey, hey, hey. You think I'm so simplistic? Why am I to you and your tricks?
think about it. No responsibility. What's that? Responsibility. Not quite me. Responsibility. What's that? I don't wanna think about it. We'll be there if we got it. I don't wanna think about it. Go! Thank you! You guys have a great night!
It's been quite an experience, this whole DVD. And putting on these shows with the Graceland, doing the ACEP. It's all been just like, all the stuff just crammed into a little ball, and it's just getting tightly wound. And hopefully, in the end, it'll come out, break apart, and be a diamond. We'll see. That's so cheesy.